Let's see how different scopes work and what they are used for. If you're working on a single monitor, the scopes are usually placed in the bottom right corner of the screen. If you don't see them, try pressing the scopes icon, which looks like a graph. If you have two screens, the scopes will appear on the second screen. You can also bring them out as a separate window by going to Workspace, then Video Scopes, and clicking On. This window can be placed wherever you like. A good rule of thumb is to keep the scopes as big as possible, as they are useful for judging your grade. Let's now look at the different scopes. The one you might be most familiar with is the histogram. The histogram displays each pixel from 0 on the left, which is pure black, to 100 on the right, which is pure white. The higher the graph, the more pixels fall in that luminosity value. By itself, the histogram doesn't give you much information about the picture you're looking at, apart from a very generic idea of its exposure. If the image is clipped, you'll see it on the histogram. A much better tool to understand your image is the waveform. The waveform displays each pixel in your image from 0 at the bottom, which is pure black, to 100 at the top, which is pure white. But it also ranges them from left to right, where the left side corresponds to the left side of the image and the right side to the right side of the image. For example, this is a frame for a video I directed for Maserati. You can see there are two specular tube lights on the top section of the frame, on the left side and the right side. You can see them in the waveform here and here. In the middle, there's a window on the ceiling, and you can also see it in the middle of the waveform. This next image is very low-key. It comes from a project on artificial intelligence. As you can see, the image is very dark, but the Android in the middle is quite bright. The first spike on the left of the waveform is the shirt, and the second is the arm. You can also see some light from the tables on the sides. A nice way to see where your image falls in the waveform is to click the Scopes menu here and toggle on Display Qualifier Focus. Then select the Qualifier tool. Now, if you move over your image, DaVinci will show you where the pixels are in the waveform. This next image, on the other hand, is high key. You can see that in the waveform, as most of the image is above 40 to 50% luminosity. Here, I can observe the difference in brightness across various parts of the scene and decide how to adjust them. The waveform is very useful to decide where each element of your scene should fall in the spectrum. To learn more about this, check out the Ansel Adams Zone system. I'll make a video about it in the future as well. Waveforms are by far the scope I use the most. The parade is a more complex visualization of the waveform. It still represents the image from left to right and the brightness from bottom to top. But here, the three channels, red, green, and blue, are represented separately. With this tool, the image is squeezed, so you lose the proportion of the image compared to the waveform. This makes it harder to judge where an element is sitting. But it is a great tool for white balancing or balancing clips between each other. Let's take this clip from Maserati, for example. Here you can see the grade has a pretty strong bluish tint, which is there on purpose. If you want to balance the logo so it's white again, you can align the three waves in the parade by going to the RGB mixer, which is in the tools here. Disable preserve luminance and adjust the red and blue outputs up and down until the waves are aligned. If you're interested in this technique, there is a great tutorial online by Darren Mostyn that shows you how to do it. The last tool for judging the color grade is the Vectorscope. This tool is used to display color and saturation. The center of the wheel represents zero saturation. The farther you move from the center, the more saturated the colors become. The colors are arranged in the same order you see in the color wheels, with the red at the top center, going clockwise through magenta, blue, cyan, green, and yellow. Let's use this example from Maserati. Here is a detail of their new engine called Nettuno. This is a monochromatic scene, and you can see that the colors in the scope go from the saturated up to the letter C. If you move the hue around, you can see the color rotating in the scope. This image is quite saturated, so you can actually see the wave reaching the edge of the Rec. 709 color space while moving. This happens because it clashes with the limit of color representation in that color space, which we can see in the CIE chromaticity window. To learn more about color spaces, check out my other video on DaVinci White Gamut and Rec. 709. The Vectorscope is very useful for judging not only saturation, but also skin color. If you go into Vectorscope menu and toggle Show Skin Tone Indicator, a line will appear in the Vectorscope. This is the skin tone line, and it tells you where most skin colors fall in the color wheel, regardless of ethnicity. Let's take this clip for example. This is from a corporate video I made a few years ago that has a distinct yellow tint. You can tell that the skin is not in the correct space, as it's on the left side of the line. If you want to bring the skin to a more natural tone, you can move the offset wheel to bring the color back over the line. This clip then naturally falls back into the orange and teal look, as it was filmed mixing tungsten and daylight lights.